So hope you're okay. Today we're here to share with you the gospel. Today says in the word of God. So loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. That God offers eternal life today. He offers you eternal life today. You cannot pay for it. You don't pay for it. You don't spend millions of pounds so that you can have eternal life. You don't buy a lottery ticket so that you could have eternal life. You have to realize that eternal life is a free gift. That eternal life is a free gift. That God gave a free gift. He says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. And God offered his own Son. He offered his own Son that you and I might live. He says, a son is given, Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6, a son is given. That God gave a son is given. And God gave his own Son. He gave his own Son to die on that cross. He gave his own Son to die on that cross. And when his own Son died on that cross, it was to give eternal life. Eternal life. A son is given. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. A son is given. God gave his Son. And when his Son died on that cross, when his Son died on that cross, a son was given. He was given. He was given that you may have life. That you may have hope. A son is given. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. A son is given. And God gave his Son, Jesus Christ. And when Christ died on that cross, he died as a sacrifice for our sin. Said in the Ten Commandments, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. That we shouldn't worship idols. We shouldn't worship the computer. We shouldn't worship anything, he says. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. We made secularism and political correctness a god. He says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. And we as a people have lost the vision of who God is. We the people have lost the vision of who the true and living God is. And we've become blinded by the world. We've become blinded by secularism. We've been blinded by the trinkets of this world that have blinded us. Blinded us with sex. Blinded us with drugs. Blinded us. Secularism has blinded us. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Yet we have made political correctness a god. We have made secularism as a god. We have made materialism as a god. And we are like the blind walking and following the blind. And we have become blind. And we've become desensitized to the Bible. We've become desensitized to the gospel. Because we've been drugged by the pleasures of the world. We've been drugged by the pleasures of the world. I want my retirement. I want my drugs. I want my sex. I want my lottery tickets. And we've become blinded by the world. We've become blind and leaders of the blind. The Prime Minister doesn't know where she's going. The police don't know where they're going. The National Health Service doesn't know where it's going. Nobody knows where they are going. Because we have become blind. Blind. Leaders of the blind. But he says, a son is given. God gave his son. A light to Israel and a light to the Gentiles. God smote his own son. God put him on a cross. And God punished him. And when he died on that cross, he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? And as he shed his blood on that cross, he made a way to the living God. He made a way to the living God. As he shed his blood, he made a way to the living God. Political correctness cannot get you to God. Secularism cannot get you to God. Drugs cannot get you to God. Sex cannot get you to God. Lottery tickets cannot get you to God. But Christ can. He paved the way on the cross. He shed his blood on the cross. He laid down his life on the cross and shed his blood that you and I can be saved. That you and I can be born again and children of God.
That's yours, yeah.
He died that you may live. He died that you may have life. If you want to get to God, you cannot do it with lottery tickets. You cannot do it with porn. You cannot do it with drugs. You cannot do it with political correctness. The only way to God is Christ. Christ alone. We had a judge in Bristol. A judge in Bristol who said the King James Version is not to be read today. A judge in Bristol said the King James Version should not be read. I say to that judge in Bristol, you are to be ashamed of yourself. Ashamed of yourself to say that. The King James Bible is a wonderful Bible. He came to die on that cross. He shed his blood. There is only one way to God, and that is Christ. Christ is the only way. The judge at Bristol said to say that Jesus is the truth is not right. That you cannot say that. The judge at Bristol said to say that Jesus is the truth is not right. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The judge at Bristol is wrong. Jesus is the only way to God. The only way to God, the only way to heaven is Christ. And if you want to go to heaven, it's knowing Christ. And if you don't know him, if you don't know him, if you've not closed with the Lord, if you've not come to know his love, if you've not come to know his mercy, if you've not come to know him, then you're going to be lost. The greatest question today is, what do you think of Christ? My friends, the day of political correctness is over. The day of materialism is over. The day is over. It's today. We need to trust the Lord. Today, we need to trust the Lord. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or likeness anything that is in the heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath. Thou shalt not make any graven images. We'll make graven images of corporate capitalism. Is an image that we worship. Our computers we worship. We worship all these things. But we do not worship the living God. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord in vain.
Rest in him.
There is power.